Let's talk about ET for a moment. Is there any research being done to help better manage this condition?
Yeah, I would say that of the three MPNs, ET is certainly the one that has the least amount of drugs that are being currently studied for this group, but that doesn't mean that there isn't any research. Ropig interferon, which was recently approved in essential thrombocythemia and polycythemia vera, is now being studied in essential thrombocythemia. So I would expect in the next couple of years, if those trials are successful, to have ropig interferon as a therapy to offer patients. There's also a clinical trial that we have at our site where we're using ruxolitinib or Jakafi for patients with ET that have symptoms of their disease to see if it can help them in the same way that it can help PV or myelofibrosis patients. So there's definitely some research going on in ET, but probably less than for PV and myelofibrosis.
While ET is typically well managed, what patient type might benefit from joining a trial?
It really depends on what the patient is experiencing. I think there are some patients that really are very asymptomatic and can expect to have an excellent outcome with their disease, but they can also participate in research, for example, by participating in a tissue bank and offering, you know, a sample of their blood, or if they have a bone marrow, by offering some bone marrow if there's extra, because that can really help to understand why the disease biology, if a patient is going to progress from ET to myelofibrosis. So we can learn a lot from that. But then there are maybe some ET patients that need to be on a medication to reduce their blood counts or a cytoreductive agent. And that's a patient that could ask about participation in a clinical trial, for example, the ropig interferon study. Or like I mentioned, there may be some patients that maybe are already on a medication and their blood counts aren't well controlled on the first drug that was used. So before considering switching to a second line agent or a second medication, they could inquire with their clinician if there's a clinical trial available for second line use, or those patients that have a lot of symptoms with ET, they could potentially be eligible for a study that addresses just symptoms.